All right, welcome back. Let's get it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bullpen. You have seen the viral video of Mr. Tony Nguyen, who was wrongfully arrested at a Walmart. Let me take you to that video, and I also have the 911 call, and I have Mr. Nguyen on the show. Here it is.
Here.
That's not
bad. A year?
Yes, you can't come back.
That was like 10, 15 years ago.
What are you talking about?
There's no limit on that.
We are grocery shopping. What are you talking about?
You're trespassing the store. You're not allowed to be here, all right?
It said 10, 15 years ago.
No. Let's go.
Where are you taking him? What the? Where are you taking him?
Once you trespass as well, so let's go.
For what? For grocery shopping?
Hey, that guy right there.
No, for being trespassed.
For grocery shopping?
Hey, look, record him right there.
So the trespass has been confirmed. He has been trespassed here actually this year. So he will not be staying here. He's going to be going to jail tonight. All right, I need you to get in the car and drive away, because if you come back here, you're going to also be going to jail for trespass, okay?
This is disgusting.
I'm sorry you feel that way.
I'm literally going to go into seizure.
If you go into seizure, let me know. I'll have EMS come out.
His girlfriend, Lauren, was there, baffled, obviously, by what was happening. Once again, he was wrongfully arrested. We have the proof of that. Now, here's the 911 call that sparked the entire incident. Here it is.
Fernando County Sheriff's Office, operative 43, the phone's recorded. Okay, tell me exactly what happened.
There is an Asian male in the store right now. His name is Cody Vonderlin. He is trespassed from the store. He is not allowed to be here, and he also tends to be violent and carries weapons.
What is he wearing?
I did not get a great look at him. I think it's like a blue long sleeve shirt and a backwards hat. I didn't want to make eye contact with him because he's very aggressive and he knows who I am.
Okay, give me one moment to know that.
Okay, Julie Emmer's called with dispatch, sorry.
Yeah, he's looking for you.
Where is he?
HVA.
He's looking for me?
Yeah, he's standing at Rashad's shop and he's standing in Action Alley looking around looking for you.
Yeah, this guy's got to, he's got to get arrested. I'm tired. He can't be in here. This guy absolutely sucks.
Okay, you said he's very aggressive and he carries weapons?
He tends to carry knives on his person, yes. And he is very confrontational, very aggressive.
Okay.
Still looking around, looking for you.
Does he have a vehicle?
The last time he was here, he was also trespassing. He came in like a giant Hummer with a trailer on it. I did not see what car he arrived in today.
First of all, that's a scary ass security guard. Who is afraid to make eye contact with someone and you signed up to be a security guard? Number one. Number two. His name is not Cody. That was the wrong person. The security guard said first and last name. The individual that the officers arrested did not match. First and last name given to the 911 operator. That didn't matter. They still decided to effect an arrest. There's some nuance here that must be discussed. Tony Nguyen, thank you for joining the program. We appreciate your time, sir. How are you?
Good, how about you, sir?
I'm doing well, man. Sorry this happened to you, but we're going to get into the nitty gritty. And you do have a court date coming up. Let me first ask you, were you the person who they were referring to in that particular arrest?
Correct.
You were not the person.
Oh, no, I was not the person, correct.
Okay. Now, did the officer ever tell you, hey, we're looking for somebody named Cody. Is your name Cody? Can I see some ID? Did that ever happen? That never happened.
Never.
Okay. At what point did you realize that you were going to be arrested? Give us the scene in your own words.
Basically, once he put me behind in the cop car, I knew I was going to jail. At that point, he was convinced that I was trespassing 2018, and for some odd reason, and I didn't know anything about a Cody, so he was convinced I was trespassing. I'm, you know, so at that point, I didn't know. A name wasn't brought up. So I was just assuming that he knew I was, my name was Tony.
Let's highlight something here. When you first, when the encounter first happened, how did it go down inside of that Walmart?
I was just, I was looking at some toys, I believe, in the toy aisle, Hot Wheels. And he just came from behind me and said, "You're under arrest for trespassing."
That's it.
That's it. Literally what you see on the video.
At any point, did they try to confirm your identification as it relates to the 911 call?
Never, sir.
Okay, so that's obviously a violation. We do have a picture of the man, Cody, that they were referring to. If the producers can put that picture up, that's Cody. That's the person, according to the authorities, and according to the narrative, that's the person they were actually looking for. Now, they chose not to verify your identity. You get arrested, you take that ride. What happens next?
So on the way to the jail, he's telling me, "Oh, it was you." And then I was trespassed on this year as well. So at this point, I'm confused, and I kept telling him, I'm like, this isn't me. I'm confused. I'm confused. Like, I was never trespassed. So and that was pretty much, just me saying that I was never trespassed, whatever. And that's just the ride going to the jail.
Okay. Obviously, this could have been a very dangerous situation for you, because the way the call came in, they said you were basically armed and dangerous, that you were aggressive, that they were afraid of you. This could have gone down a completely different way, especially if you would have been, let's say, more aggressive about not getting arrested, which would have been understandable, correct?
Correct. So, okay. That's one thing that I really wanted to point out too. That's funny, because it's sad that it takes, somebody's death to get that attention. Mm-hmm. Like, imagine if I would have spazzed out, I would have got that attention I needed, but at the same time, I would be dead. So that's a crazy part. And yeah, like he said, it over a misunderstanding, I could have been dead because he said I was armed and dangerous. Now let's say five, a SWAT team would have pulled up and, I would have did one thing, spazzed up, I would have, done, I would have got killed on spot.
Yeah. And that's how serious this is. So let me ask you about Walmart. The security guard obviously works for Walmart. The employee or employees that back this play, they work for Walmart. Has Walmart or Walmart security said anything to you? An apology, a letter, a conversation?
No, the funny thing is that they're actually on my channel bashing me now. They're talking down on me. They're telling my, my subscribers that, I was threatening them or whatever the, whatever their comments are.
That's very unfortunate. At this point, is there a consideration to litigate against Walmart for this false arrest?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Now, you said something during the false arrest that I need to examine with you, okay? You said, that was 10, 15 years ago. Explain what happened 10 or 15 years ago.
So, my arrest in 2013 was for a petty theft. I did get arrested from that Walmart for a petty theft. Okay. Long story short, I had teeth work. I had my wisdom tooth pulled, and it was completely removed. I wasn't supposed to drive to the dentist or leave the dentist, so I was under influence. And the dentist's office was across the street from that Walmart. So I went to the Walmart somehow. I don't recall most of this stuff. I'm just reading. This is what I read on the report. I bought a gun safe and some other stuff, and supposedly went out and came back in and got the same thing, but I had a pocket full of money at the time, and that's all I recall. So they trespassed me for that for a year, and I went to court, and I was sentenced to 6 months on probation with early term with 2 months.
Okay.
And I was off in 2 months.
So this is really interesting. You did have a trespass many years ago, as you said to the officer, you were honest about that. That was not a lie, that was you being honest. They still did not check who you were compared to what the 911 caller said. In addition to that, when you have a trespass and you come back to a business and they transact business with you, according to judicial theory and judicial ruling,
right,
they have now forfeited the trespass, meaning you're allowed to come back to the property. There's no longer criminal dynamic connected to your trespass. Has anybody explained this to you since this happened?
So I've had one person that actually said that to me. The second day being out of jail, I don't want to say his name yet. Okay. But basically, it's now like, since I've been coming back, it's no and void, I guess. I'm a customer now, a repeat.
Yeah, that's right. And typically, a company will trespass you for 1 year or so. They usually won't ban you forever.
Walmart credit card, too. I've had a Walmart credit card for like 5 or 6, maybe longer, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
What
has this experience done for you? How do you feel after it?
Honestly, like, I'm stressing every day. Like, it's sad. It's mentally, emotionally, like, physically draining. Like, I barely eat. I barely sleep. Like, I have to worry about, you know, when I drive now. Like, when I go to stores, like, hey, you know, it's crazy. Like, I see it on TV all the time, but I never thought it would be me.
Right.
And I'm glad I didn't, you know, spaz out or react in a different way, because I would have been dead by now.
Yeah, I commend you, sir. I commend you for the way you responded in the middle of really an impossible situation. You did nothing wrong. You did nothing illegal. You were not the person they said you were. You were not the individual named Cody, and you had committed absolutely no crime. At this point, obviously, Walmart looks as if they're going to double down. If you recall, Walmart has a zero tolerance policy as it relates to theft. I'm asking you to have a zero tolerance policy as it relates to somebody violating your rights, okay?
All the way, sir. We're going all the way.
Thank you, brother. All right, I'm going to continue to update and follow this story as it develops. If you have some additional information, please don't hesitate to contact us here, okay?
All right, thank you.
All right, good luck to you, man.
Thank you, sir.